Hi everyone, I'm Ed Hyland. This is ASA TV. I'm joined now by Dr. Lee Fleisher, who is the chairman of the Ad Hoc Committee for ASA for the Brain Health Initiative. Dr. Fleisher, good to see you once again, sir.
It's a pleasure.
Let's talk a little bit about the Brain Health Initiative. First, a little backdrop, if you will, of exactly what it is, kind of how long it's been going on and how long it's going to last.
Well, about 18 months ago, Dan Cole, the previous president of the ASA, and I spoke about the opportunity to really develop a new initiative around patient safety. And in trying to define that, Dan thought of the idea of perioperative brain health, the issue of both delirium and cognitive dysfunction. Delirium being something that multiple stakeholders have been involved in. The cognitive changes after surgery and anesthesia really being something that we've owned quite a bit. So we sat together and we actually formed a committee and we brought together multiple stakeholders, both payers, providers, patient groups, and asked how can we inform the public, how can we inform payers and providers, and how can we inform hospitals about what are the tools and resources needed to make them more aware of the problems and decrease the issues of delirium and hopefully cognitive dysfunction after surgery.
I understand a three-year program, I believe.
We hope a multi-year program because really the goal is long-term to improve the care of patients undergoing surgery and anesthesia, especially those over 65, the older population. So hopefully the initiative will be ongoing, but the campaign really is a three-year campaign.
Let's get an idea of exactly why it's important to ASA members as well as patients.
Well, we certainly focus on things that we can directly control. This is something that we jointly own with our surgical colleagues and our hospital colleagues. And anything we can do to improve the care of the elderly patient is a good thing.
Give us some thoughts on what you've been able to accomplish in, say, the last year or so.
So we've gone silent. We talked about it a lot when we first launched it. It was in the ASA monitor. We've had this multi-stakeholder group who met in Washington, but we spent the last year really developing a microsite that's off of the main ASA homepage and developing tools and resources that patients and providers can use, as well as thinking about how do we sort of enhance the strategy by what kind of stories could we use that we're going to ask ASA members, tell us what you're doing so we can learn from each other. All that will be on the website. We've also developed a hashtag, perioperative brain health, or periop brain health, that will allow us people to keep track of the newest and greatest information that's out there in the literature, as well as the new stories, quality improvement stories.
Let's talk a little bit about the future. Look in the crystal ball for us and what may come up over the next year, at least what you hope to accomplish.
So in the next year, we hope that people will begin to ask our patients, that providers, that anesthesiologists and the rest of the anesthesia care team ask patients, do they have any risk factors for memory problems? That we carefully educate them that there are things they can do to reduce those risks. Bringing in things from home like making sure they have their glasses, making sure they have hearing aids, but maybe even pictures of loved ones, maybe even telling what you watch on TV at different times of the day so that when you're in the hospital, you can be oriented quicker. That we work with our hospital IT departments. Do we give diphenhydramine after surgery on the ward? Can we as anesthesiologists really take leadership to educate our surgical colleagues? There are drugs in these patients that increase these risks, and should you think twice before you give them? So those are sort of the short-term goals, and importantly, getting people to give us stories of success so that others can learn and implement them locally.
And a reminder, hashtag periop brain health.
Absolutely, and just follow us and please come to the website because we really made it. ASA did a phenomenal job in developing these resources. We've shown them to ARP, AARP. We've shown them to the American Hospital Association, the American Heart Association, and all these groups who are part of our stakeholder group are excited that there is now one place to find these resources.
And on that note, Dr. Lee Fleisher, thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
And this is ASA TV.